video, I'm going to show you how you can create very fast and easy some nice Druzy inlay molds. Here you can see it. And another one. And another one. I'm so sorry for my French bulldog. He's making some really hard noises again. But yeah, you can make them really fast and easy, but not by growing your own crystals, but by using some crystal glass, not real glass, but plexiglass. And I came to the idea when I stood in our kitchen and I looked at our door and I thought, we live in a very old home, so we have glass in our doors. And I watched that glass and I thought, our glass also has some crystal effects. So I looked closer and I thought, yeah, that's really nice. But I couldn't pour on our glass door. So I searched the internet and I found some really nice crystal plexiglass. I'm going to show you it, because in another part of this video you will see how I make these silicon Druzy molds and using that plexiglass. But this is the plexiglass, you can see, very sparkly. And this same glass we also have in our doors, but they're not made out of plexiglass, but real glass. So I wanted to show you this before you watch how I make these Druzy molds. Then you know how it looks, and it has a flat size side and a nice crystal side, and it sparkles a lot. So this is what I used. You can also buy it in smaller pieces. I bought it here in the Netherlands. I don't know if you can buy it outside of the Netherlands, but I put a link below this video. And I also will include a photo of our kitchen door, so you can see that it's the same. And I hope you will enjoy this video, and I will all see you the next time. Bye. So in this part of the video, I'm going to show you how to make the base mold for the Druzy inlay molds. And so you can see, I'm using the crystal plexiglass, and on top I'm using three cookie cutters in different shapes. And I need to make sure that these cookie cutters are attached to the crystal plexiglass. So I'm using a soft molding dough, also to prevent that the silicon will leak underneath the cookie cutter. So that's not good. So that's why I'm sealing it with a soft molding dough. There you can see it. And these cookie cutters are very cheap. Also the link in the description below this video, also the molding dough. Again, the soft molding dough, pressing it against the side of the cookie cutter. There you can see it. So it's very easy. And this method is very fast, because if you want to grow your crystals, it takes a very long time. I will include a link in the right corner, because I also have a video of that, so you can see the difference.
But yeah, the only thing with this crystal plexiglass is that it looks not that real, but still sparkles a lot. And if you grow your own crystals from alum salt, yeah, the crystals look much more real than this. But yeah, if you want to have your Druzy inlay molds, if you want to have them fast, and not that you do not want to spend that much time making them, then this is a great method to make these silicon inlay molds. And these inlay molds you can use in another silicon mold. But what you can also do is that you add them on top of your resin layer. Your last top coat resin layer. Because then you get the crystal effect on top of your resin art. And these are about 10 centimeters. So you can use them in a coaster mold or in a tray mold. For in another video, I'm going to show you how to use these inlay molds. But you can make any shape you want because there are a lot of different cookie cutters. And also you don't need a lot of silicon rubber for these Druzy inlay molds because those inlay molds don't need to be that thick. So the base molds are done. Now I'm going to pour some silicon rubber. I'm using the silicon rubber from the Resin Pro company. It's a transparent, yeah, semi-transparent silicon rubber, and it's a one-to-one ratio. And what I always do is pour from up high in a thin stream, bit by bit, so not too much silicon rubber at once, because this way the air bubbles can escape from your silicon rubber. There you can see it. Pouring it on top of the crystal plexiglass. And I think I've used about less than 100 gram. So that's not a lot. Bit by bit I'm adding the silicon rubber. The last one. Yeah, and I think this is a great way to make your Druzy inlay molds. Fast and easy. So I'm almost done with filling the base mold with the silicon rubber. Need to let this dry. And Then I will show you all how I take them out of the mold. And of course also the end result of the Druzy inlay molds. So we are 24 hours later. Now I'm going to take the Druzy inlay molds out of the base molds using a wooden stick. And I know the silicon rubber doesn't stick to the cookie cutter because it's made out of plastic, but also not on the crystal plexiglass. And the first one is almost out of the mold. Very carefully. The second one, the flower. And I think they are about 5 millimeters thick, but you can also make them a little bit thinner. But yeah, this is my first experiment with this crystal plexiglass, but also with the cookie cutters. I never used them before, but I wanted to show you this experiment. And hopefully I've inspired you all. And the last one. Yeah, and that crystal plexiglass you can use over and over again. Also that soft molding dough, because it will not, it will stay soft. A little bit closer, yeah, I need to work on the edges. But it looks great, it sparkles a lot. The second one. So this is a fast and easy way to make your own Druzy inlay molds. And the last one, also very nice. This is the end result. I have them outside in the daylight. There you can see the texture of the crystal effect and the sparkle. I think they look amazing. This was a very good experiment, and I hope I inspired you all to also try this. The link to the crystal plexiglass is below this video. I don't know if you can buy it outside of the Netherlands, but then you can see how it looks and search for it yourself. Hopefully you can see the sparkle. So in the next project I will use these inlay molds. I hope you enjoyed this video and consider to subscribe. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up for this video. All the information to the supplies I've used is in the description box. I want to thank you all for watching again, and hopefully I will see you in the next video. Bye!